But I want to welcome each pastor, please, 5 minutes, each 5 minutes. Who wants to be last? Hallelujah. We're going to give Sister Pat an opportunity. Come on up here, Sister Pat. The steps are right up there in the name of Jesus Christ. And share about 5 minutes, sister, for the glory of God. I will try to. I will try to. Amen.
Get your phone.
I don't need a mic. Can y'all hear me back there?
Hallelujah. Yes, sister. For the time is short. The time is short. Arise and walk. Walk in that which the Lord has given unto you this day. He has a plan and a purpose for your lives. And the harvest is white. They need the word. And you have been called to deliver that word. The hand of the Lord is upon you this day. You were not here by chance. But God's plan and his purpose, my brother, is for you. May the Lord bless and keep you. And I have a word for this brother. I did not understand one word you sang. But the Lord says that you are his flame of fire. And this fire is going to ignite the fire of the Holy Ghost in his people. And you're going to raise them up. And they're going to walk in the Spirit. Because you're walking in the Spirit. You sang in the Spirit. I did not understand, but it ministered to me. And the Lord says, you are my flame of fire for this hour. Amen.
Thank you, Sister Pat. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father God. Brother Frank, if you have 5 minutes, come on up here, brother. You can get up on the pulpit if you like. Steps are right over there. The elevator's around the back. Hallelujah. And again, y'all pray for Hector Herrera. He blessed us with his building. Pray for him. Just remember Hector Herrera. God knows. You just pray for him in the middle of the night, 3 a.m. Señor, por Hector Herrera. God knows. In the name of Jesus Christ, bless him. Bless them, Father. Hallelujah. All right, Pastor. This is a brother from a Pentecostal brother. We're going to really keep time on this brother. Hallelujah.
A su nombre. Now I don't know why you told me to get up here behind the pulpit, but that way I can't see you and you can't see me. I knew he had something up his sleeve. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Brothers and sisters, I want to read one portion of the word. And I don't mean to sound like I'm getting after you. No te estoy regañando. I'm not. No te estoy regañando. Te estoy aconsejando. Amén. Porque lo mismo que yo te digo a ti es para mí también. Amén. Whatever I say to you, that goes for me too. Amen. I'm in the book of Matthew, and I'm chapter 12 and verse 36. And I want you to listen real close. Estoy en el libro de Mateo 12:36. Y te lo voy a leer para que lo tomes en tu corazón y lo pongas por obra. Y cada vez que se te quiera salir una cosa de la boca, every time something wants to leave out of your mouth, check it before it leaves. Investígalo antes de que te salga de la boca. Amen. And I'm going to read it in the holy name of Jesus. It says, but I say unto you that every idle word that men shall speak, they shall give account thereof in the day of judgment. Que por cada palabra ociosa que salga de nuestra boca, daremos cuenta. So, antes de que salga la palabra de tu boca, chequéala, investigala. Before it leaves your mouth, you know why? I'm going to tell you something. I want you to listen close to what I'm going to tell you. Have you ever heard something crazy in the court that says, ignore what he just said? Have you ever heard that? Ignore it. En la corte a veces dicen, ¿sabes qué? Ignore lo que acaba de oír. ¿Cómo lo vas a ignorar? ¿Tú ya lo oíste? ¿Cómo lo vas a... How can you ignore it? You already heard it. It's already said, you heard it. It's already taken action within you. Something is already working. So that's nonsense. So before it leaves your mouth, check it. Antes de que se arranque de tu boca, investigalo, porque no lo puedes traer para atrás. You can't go, oh, I didn't mean that. What I meant was too bad. It's already left your mouth. Amen. Brother Pastor, God bless you. God bless each and every one of you. Teen challenge. I know you went through, let me use this word, you went through hell. Because it looked like it was hell while you were going through it, right? But he brought you through it. He brought you out of hell to a place now that you can say, oh, I'm living in heaven. A cada uno de ustedes, Dios los bendiga, Dios los guarde. Dios sea glorificado en el cielo, en la tierra y en todo lugar. May God be blessed in the heavens and the earth and below the earth and everywhere. God bless you.
Pastor Frank Castillo. Aleluya. Y así dice Jehová. Hermano Pastor Luján, pase para adelante, hermano. Aleluya. Watch that chair right there. Move that chair. Praise the Lord. Siervo.
Dios les bendiga, God bless you. Dios les bendiga a todos. El hermano me dio 5 horas para predicar. O cinco minutos mexicanos, amén. He said 5 minutes, I'm going to take 5 Mexican minutes. Amén. It'll be about 5 hours. No, it's not true. When I got here to the old church, to your church, I saw a sign there. Vi un sign ahí. I said, 13 years of fighting cancer. It's still long ways to go. Voy a pedirle al hermano que me traduzca para poder agarrar los 5 minutos y no voy a ir más. So help me, brother. No importa su posición. Lo que importa es su condición. La posición no te traerá la bendición, sino la condición es la que va a determinar que eres bendito. Oí el testimonio de las hermanitas de Teen Challenge. ¿Y qué puedo predicar? Ellas predicaron a mi vida. Dios les bendiga. Dios les prospere. Dios les aumente las bendiciones. Tu posición. ¿Dónde está la que canta? Tu posición. O la posición de alguien más no determina una relación con Dios. No importa que estabas abajo o alguien esté arriba, eso no determina la bendición. Tu condición de sierva es lo que determina tu bendición. Hay pastores, maestros, profesionales en la enseñanza, y pueden ser grandes hombres, cultos, sabios, pero ellos no pueden formar, solo sembrar una semilla de esperanza en el corazón de quien no los oye. Y aunque no ven o no pueden ser testigos de lo que Dios está haciendo en su corazón, lo único que saben, que Dios les llamó para preparar un camino para que el que escucha la voz de Dios llegue al propósito. Tú has sido de bendición hoy, porque muchos han escuchado tu fervor, tu pasión y tu amor a Dios. Muchos dicen amo a Dios, pero yo pregunto, ¿qué es amar a Dios? Amar a Dios es servir a otros, someterse a Él y serle fiel. Si hacemos eso, la bendición será sobre nosotros. La palabra declara: busca primero el reino de Dios y su justicia, y todo lo demás vendrá por añadidura. Yo les exhorto, hermanos, yo les animo que continúen alimentando la esperanza, porque aquel que nos llamó, aquel que inició la obra en ti y en mí, seguramente la terminará en el día de su venida. ¡Yeah! ¡Aleluya! ¡Aleluya! Yo doy gracias a Dios porque puedo estar aquí, aunque sea un momento, para ver con gran gozo la transformación que ha hecho Dios en cada uno. Pastor, gracias por sus palabras. Fernando, gracias, hermano, por tu amistad. Te amo. Y nosotros, como siervos de Dios, tenemos que tener siempre en memoria que hemos recibido al Señor como Señor, y que nosotros somos sus siervos. Y lo que nos dé, lo que nos pueda dar, es para bendecir a otros. Continúa, hermano. Continúa, hermano. Continúa, hermano. Continúa, hermana, testificando las cosas grandes y hermosas que Dios ha hecho en tu vida. Amén. Dios me los bendiga. La gloria sea al Señor. Aleluya.
Hallelujah. Pues, hermano, I don't think he's a Mexican. I think he's French. Hallelujah. Pastor Carlos Espinosa, pásele, siervo. 5 minutes, and that way we can move on in the name of Jesus. And it's an honor for my to have my dad here. Pásate, daddy, pásate. Por allá está más easier. Allá está el elevator. Hallelujah. It's an honor. This is my dad. Everybody that don't know my dad, ese es mi papá, Carlos Espinosa, el que quebró la maldición de nuestra familia, the one who broke the curse out of our family, the traditions, la maldición de tradiciones. Él se entregó a Cristo, y aquí está la segunda generación sirviendo al Rey de Reyes por este siervo. Thank you, daddy.
Thank you so much. May that be for the Lord. I want to thank God for the privilege and for the opportunity to be here today. And I want to thank my wife and my daughter who are standing over there, driving over here. And I want to ask you three questions before I read something out of the Bible. How many know that Jesus is here? Raise your hand. ¿Cuántos creen que el Señor está aquí? The Bible says where there's two or three gathered together in my name, I will be in the midst of them. Praise the Lord. And there's more than three here tonight. Y hay más de tres aquí en esta noche. Okay. Ahora, second question. How many know for sure that God can hear your prayers? Raise your hand. ¿Cuántos de los que están aquí saben por seguro que Dios le escucha su oración? Tercero, third question. How many of you that are here tonight, raise your hand, they're sure that God can hear, can see your tears running down your cheek? ¿Cuántos de ustedes están seguros que Dios puede verle las lágrimas cuando usted llora? Now, ahora se lo voy a probar. Now I'm going to prove it to you. Voy a leer una porción en my Bible. It's in heavenly language, okay? It's in Spanish. Second Kings chapter 20, verses 1-6. Mi Biblia está en el lenguaje celestial, está en español. Segunda de Reyes, capítulo 20, del 1 al 6. Dice así, le voy a leer rápido. En aquellos días de Ezequías cayó enfermo de muerte y vino a él el profeta Isaías, hijo de Amós, y le dijo: Jehová dice así, ordena tu casa, porque morirás y no vivirás. Second, entonces él volvió su rostro a la pared y oró a Jehová y dijo: Te ruego, oh Jehová, te ruego que hagas memoria de que ando delante de ti en verdad y con íntegro corazón, y que he hecho las cosas que te agradan. Y lloró Ezequías con gran lloro. Cuarto, antes que Isaías saliese a la mitad del patio, vino palabra de Jehová a Isaías diciendo: Vuélvete y di a Ezequías, príncipe de mi pueblo, así dice Jehová, el Dios de David, tu padre, yo he oído, escuche bien, I have heard your prayer, yo he visto las lágrimas de tus ojos. He aquí que yo te sano al tercer día. Behold, I have heard your prayer, and I have seen your tears running down your eyes. Therefore, I will heal you, says the Lord. Y añadiré a tus días 15 años y te libraré a ti y a esta ciudad de mano del rey de Asiria. Praise the Lord. And I will give you the medicine, and I will heal you, and I will give you 15 more years of life, and I will restore the city for my name's sake. Noten algo bien importante que dice el mensaje. The message is very clear. El mensaje está bien claro, mi hermano. El mensaje de Juan el Bautista: arrepiéntete, mi hermano. Arrepiéntete. Pon en orden tu vida. Pon en orden tu familia. ¿Ok? Porque morirás. The message is very clearly. Put your life in order. Put your house in order. For you will die. You will die. But if you will turn to the wall, get on your knees and pray, I will heal you. And I will give you 15 more years of life. Okay? But here's the last point. God today, Dios en este día te dice, arrepiéntete, mi hermano. ¿Ok? Voltea tu cara a la pared. Pon tu casa en orden. Pon tu vida en orden. Y Dios no dice, te voy a dar 15 años más de vida. Yo te voy a dar vida eterna. God does not say, I will give you 15 more days. God will say, I will give you eternal life if you will repent and turn your face to the wall and put your house in order. That's the message for today. Praise the Lord.
Come on, Papa. Gloria a Dios. Come on, Daddy. Thank you, Jesus. I love you, Daddy. Thank you, Pops. Alabado sea Jehová. And I'm not adopted, eh? So say, come on, how could that man be his daddy? That's my daddy. I thank the Lord for my dad. I've only known him for 52 years. Thank you, Jesus. Pastor Rocky, God bless you, Pastor. In Jesus' name. I'm already going to close already. I know we're all hungry. I thank God for Rocky. Pastor Rocky was out there in the storm. He was soaking wet, feet wet. Who else got their shoes wet? Somebody came and said, Emilio, he done left. But in Jesus' name, I thank God for the hard work they did. Frank and Margaret, praise God. They were all being a sister, Consuelo, all working for the glory of God. Brother Chad, he was over here early this morning. Sarah was out there in the rain. And I just may God bless them abundantly. We're going to pick up an offering. We are going to pick up an offering. Se va a levantar una ofrenda. But our members of our church, los miembros de la iglesia, be faithful with your tithes and offerings. If you're a member of another church, si eres miembro de otra iglesia, ve dar tus diezmos y tus ofrendas allá. Si traes algo para el Señor, that's between you and God. Amen? But before I get there, I just want to share a little bit in the name of Jesus Christ. We're almost done. Ya mero acabamos. Y'all give me an hour and we'll be leaving. Amen? But in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, let us pray. Vamos a orar. Padre Celestial, en el nombre de tu Hijo, Jesucristo, Señor, vengo y te doy honra y gloria. Padre, in the name of Jesus, I exalt and I glorify you, Father, that this word land on good ground, Father, in the name of Jesus Christ. First of all, I just want to thank the Lord. Le quiero dar gracias al Señor for 13 years that God, by His grace and His mercy, send His Son Jesus Christ to heal me from cancer. Que el Señor por su, en medio de su gracia y su misericordia, me sanó de cáncer. Cinco doctores, five doctors said, 1 year to go, un año, you're dead. What? Yes, we're going to send you to chemotherapy. Terapia. Amen. Amen. One of those, brother. But five doctors were telling me this. One of the doctors, I know he was confused. Un doctor me dijo, he said, I was going to turn as skinny as a pencil. You know, he was. Dijo el doctor que yo me iba a hacer delgadito como un lápiz. Y'all know he was. I think he was popping the pills in the back. I look like a truckload of pencils. Me veo como una traila de lápices. Pero el mensaje y the word is, I didn't wait on their report. Yo no esperé en el reporte del doctor. I wasn't waiting on the report of the doctors. But in intensive care unit at LBJ, they took out one kidney, two ribs. Me sacaron un riñón y dos costillas. Y yo sé que fue el favor de Dios. I know it was God's favor. I've been shot at. I've OD'd 3 times in my life. I should have been dead over and over again. But God, by His grace and His mercy, gave a hard head. Le dio un cabezón como Fernando Espinosa. A hard head like Fernando Espinosa. He gave another chance. Me dio otra chance. Cuando yo le clamé, when I called upon the name of Jesus at LBJ, cuando dije, Jesús, Jesus, help me. Everything that I learned as a child, todo lo que aprendí de niño, ahí en ese momento, at that moment, I remembered everything I learned as a child. I was raised up in the house of God. And Jesus sent 2 old ladies. El Señor envió 2 viejitas a ese cuarto. That moment that I said, Jesus, is there room in heaven? Hay lugar en el reino para un vato loco como yo. Is there room in heaven for a dude like me? And when I said, I'm going to serve you to the ends of, I have 1 year, tengo 1 año de vida, yo te voy a servir, Señor. I'm going to serve you to the ends of my days, Lord Jesus. Forgive me. When I prayed that prayer, 2 old ladies opened. Cuando yo oré esa oración, 2 ancianitas abrieron la cortina y dijeron, necesitas usted, you need us to pray for you. I said, please, por favor. They laid hands on me in the name of Jesus Christ. En el nombre del Señor Jesucristo, oraron por mí. 4 días, 4 days later, I was at my house. I should have been there in a month. Un mes debía estar en el hospital. Pero Jesús llegó a ese cuarto. Dice la palabra de Dios, no tienes. The word of God says, you have not, because you ask not. Porque no le pides. Yo no le pedí al doctor, give me some more radiation. Véntame un radiation. Dame radioactivo. No le pedí nada al doctor, pero le pedí misericordia a Jesucristo. I asked Jesus, help me.